Andrew McCusker, and I love traveling to exotic places and venturing outside of my comfort zone. I love to travel and am fortunate that I have visited 5 of the 7 continents. During my travels, I have embraced new cultures, eaten unusual food like cow's tongue, and enjoyed new experiences such as feeding a kangaroo and trekking a glacier. Because of these experiences, I think of myself as a brave and adventurous person. When I went to China with our school last year, I found it easier to try new things because I had practiced traveling with my family. However, looking back on my early middle school years, I have to admit that I wasn't as comfortable going outside of my comfort zone in my ordinary life. I'm so comfortable at St. Matthew's because I've been here since preschool. I was friends with older kids because of my older brother, and it is like a big family to me because I'm familiar with every teacher, most students, and many of their families. When we began middle school, our class became the first double section class. In 5th and 6th grade, I often hung out with kids who were older than me and socialized less with people in my own grade. I realize now that starting middle school and having many new classmates overwhelms me. Looking back, I guess I hung out with kids in the older classes because I knew all of them, so I didn't have to go out of my comfort zone and get to know my new classmates. This strategy worked for a while, and I felt safe and comfortable. Then I started to notice I was being excluded from activities involving my friends and my class because I was hanging out with the older kids instead. When I wasn't with the 7th and 8th graders, I felt out of place. Eventually, my friend Catherine sat me down and had a come-to-Jesus talk with me. She told me that all of my lifelong friends in my grade were confused, annoyed, and angry with me because they felt like I was ignoring them. Catherine helped me realize that I was hurting some of my closest friends and was missing out on a lot of fun. I realized that I needed to start hanging out with my friends in my grade again, otherwise I risked losing their friendship. So, at the end of 6th grade, I renewed these important friendships, reconnected with my old friends from my grade whom I was already comfortable with and had known my whole life. Once I became reconnected to my original class, I realized I had missed the chance to make new friends with the new students at St. Matthew's. When it was announced that we'd be the first double section class at our school, I initially was excited about the opportunity to make new friends and also a little nervous about how things would change. The first year of 2 sections, I let my nervous side win. I wish I had been my brave and adventurous kangaroo feeding self instead. However, I worried that my rekindled friendships were too fragile. With this perspective, I realized that oftentimes not welcoming and including new students isn't because someone intends to be mean or exclusionary. It's because people are afraid of how it might affect their long-standing friendships. I fell into this trap. I was worried that if I ate lunch with a group of the new kids, I would miss out on things with my existing friends. I guess I was also unsure if I had things in common with the new kids, and a little insecure about whether they might actually want to be my friends. In the scripture that Austin read for us today, Abram is told by God to leave his country, his people, and his father's household to go to the promised land, a place he wasn't familiar with. Abram went out of his comfort zone to travel to a new place where he would meet new people and live a new life. For me, the magical recipe turned out to be going on an adventure to an exotic location with people from my ordinary life. Last summer's school trip to China was the perfect opportunity for me to become better friends with my classmates whom I didn't know very well. I was a little nervous about going on the China trip. In addition to China being farther away than I had ever been without my family, none of my closest old friends in my class decided to go. But I am brave and adventurous, at least away from school, and I wasn't going to let that stop me from experiencing an amazing trip. During my trip to China, I got to know Kiana, Maddie Etheridge, Maddie Ting, Sophia, Lila, and Rosie much better. There are 6 really cool girls who joined my class in 6th grade, but I had been too chicken to make friends with them. In China, I no longer felt insecure, and I wasn't worried about what my other friends were thinking. We had no trouble talking and having lots of fun together. I'm grateful that the trip to China gave me a chance to get to know them, and I cherish their friendships. We brought these friendships back to school. Our conversations are easier and more comfortable. We can partner up in class or on a team, and I care about them and want to know how they are doing. and I no longer distinguish between old or new kids in my class. Venturing out of our comfort zone to an exotic place is easy, because we know we might not have that experience again, and there's no one there to judge us. Branching out to new classmates whom we see every day feels more risky than eating strange food and trekking on glaciers, because if we make a mistake, we can't escape that person and fly off on an airplane. We still have to face them in our everyday life. After enjoying the opportunity to become friends with my classmates on our China trip, I believe that we should treat every day as an exotic adventure, one that we might never experience again. Everyone should feel free and excited to be friends with whomever they wish. Also, it's important to give your old friends room to make new friends. I encourage you all to branch out from your close circle of friends and embrace new ones. Otherwise, you may look back and regret not coming to the glacier, eating the food, or making a new friend. And, as I now know, your old friends will continue to